The world celebrated the 50th anniversary of the first Apollo moon landings last week, and I thought this might be a good time to give you a quick update on what's happening with the UAE's space mission. Just another 60-odd days remain until Hazza Al Mansouri blasts off from Earth and plants the UAE flag on the International Space Station. That's not it. The UAE is also planning a Mars probe, aptly named Hope. In just 2 years, which is also going to be the country's 50th anniversary, the UAE will land a probe on Mars. The ultimate goal is to establish the first human colony on the red planet by 2117. The Hope probe is scheduled to lift off from Japan in July 2020 and reach Mars by 2021. The total value of Emirati investments in the space sector increased from 20 billion dirhams in 2015 to over 22 billion dirhams during the first part of last year. The number of space-related establishments in the UAE reached 57, which provided over 1,500 job opportunities. There's also going to be a new space law that's going to be launched very soon with 50 Emirati companies, institutions and establishment. Well, I had spoken to Sunil Thacker from STA Law Firm to learn more about this. Let's hear what he has to say.
The law will essentially deal with five sections or five parts. One dealing with the registration, second dealing with authorizations, third dealing with accidental investigations, auditing, and human space. The government of UAE has signed agreements with several agencies, including the ISRO, which is the Indian Space Research Organization, the JAXA, which is the Japanese arm, and also, as you mentioned, NASA earlier.
Apart from the Emirates Mars mission and the UAE Space Agency, there are other key players in all of these initiatives. The Khalifa University Lab, which is believed to be the region's first space lab, is one of them. Mohammed bin Rashid Space Research Center, which was founded by Sheikh Mohammed, is a scientific center specialized in space science and is one of the key pillars of knowledge economy. KhalifaSat, which blasted off into orbit from Japan last year, was the first satellite designed and made by Emirati engineers. Abu Dhabi's Arbar Investments, now under Mubadala, acquired a 37.8% stake in Richard Branson's Virgin Galactic, and they are in talks with the UAE Space Agency for space tourism flights from Al Ain Airport. But over the years, there have been a few roadblocks too. So earlier this month, as most of y'all know, the UAE's fourth reconnaissance satellite, Falcon I-1, was lost when the Vega rocket carrying it developed a fault. Despite the loss, preparations to launch a second satellite, Falcon I-2, are underway. The UAE even recently formed a committee responsible for detecting astronomical bodies hurtling towards Earth. So these could include meteors or the remains of spaceships or other space junk. Basically, all I'm trying to say is that the UAE is taking the space sector very seriously. And why not? According to the UAE Space Agency, in 2017, the total global space economy value amounted to $348 billion, 79% of which were commercial revenues, while 21% were for government budgets and manned spaceflight. Private investments in space grew by 30.5% in 2017 as compared to 2016. So that's it about the UAE space mission. But for more regular news updates, subscribe to our YouTube channel and of course, like, comment and share this video.